as next blue community. So I will call on Mariane to come to the podium and Don to come to the podium for the open delegation. Welcome to Barrie City Council. We have 5 minutes under our procedural bylaw and the floor is yours.
All right. Thank you very much, Your Worship, members of council. My name is Don MacNeil and I'm here with Mariane representing the Simcoe Region Chapter of the Council of Canadians, whom along with QB have initiated a project to turn Barrie and other municipalities across the country into blue communities. Becoming a blue community is achieved by protecting our water in three important ways. Number one, banning the sale of water bottles in public facilities and at municipal events. Two, commit to publicly financed, owned, and operated water and wastewater services. And three, officially recognize water as a human right. We'll go in reverse order. Water is a human right. The United Nations has already passed resolutions recognizing the human right to water and sanitation. It's entrenched in international law. It is binding. This is the easiest of the three. You simply have to add your name. Number two is promoting publicly financed, owned, and operated municipal water and wastewater services. This should be the most difficult of the three, but working the last number of years in Barrie to improve our wastewater facility and also the opening of the surface water treatment plant have turned this resolution from arduous to easy. You've already done the heavy lifting. The third and possibly most contentious is the banning of the sale and sale of bottled water in public facilities and at municipal events. Can it be achieved? The proof is actually right here in this building. City Hall long ago dispensed with the practice of dispensing water bottles. This very room right in front of you is proof as well. Glass is filled with municipal tap water. If it's good enough for this municipal building and this council, why not the rest? Now we understand this isn't going to happen overnight, nor do we expect it. But we do call for a phasing out of the sale of bottled water where there is access to clean drinking water. This also goes back to the second point, where we ask you to promote our municipal water systems through water stations installed in municipal buildings. Further proof of this can and has worked. Barrie EcoFest 2011 was bottled water free, had a mobile quench buggy. It was employed to supply cold, clean municipal water to those who participated. And this year, the theme for Barrie EcoFest, which is June 9th and 10th, by the way, will be, in fact, water. Now, in this initiative, Barrie would be neither a trailblazer nor the tip of the spear. Last year, to celebrate Water Week, which just passed, Burnaby, BC became the first blue community in Canada. This past September, Tiny Township became the first Ontario municipality to become a blue community, and the town of Midland is investigating the same. In addition, the Federation of Canadian Municipalities, which Barrie is a member, passed a resolution to encourage municipalities to phase out the sale and provision of bottled water in municipal facilities and at municipal events. 90 Canadian municipalities have followed the lead of the FCM in some way by the banning of the bottled water. U.S. mayors at their annual conference back in 2008 passed a resolution to encourage the phasing out of bottled water. Major U.S. cities and states have followed, including New York, Illinois, and California. As well, recently, a number of U.S. national parks, including the Grand Canyon, have banned the sale of bottled water inside their borders. Also, 15 universities in Canada, plus another 90 in the United States, have implemented bottled water bans, as well as a number of school boards in Canada who have implemented partial or full bans on bottled water, the sales and the purchasing thereof. Currently, the Simcoe Muskoka District School Board is contemplating a student resolution, a student-initiated resolution, to have a bottled water ban in their schools as well. So basically what we're saying is there's nothing new here. Basically all we're asking you to do, pardon the pun, is to go with the flow. I would like at this time to introduce Mariane Cancilla. She's been spearheading our campaign, and she'd like to make a special invitation to you.
Thank you very much for the opportunity to speak to you tonight. And there was a group of young people from Pope John's School here in Barrie, along with their teacher, Sherry Garland, who were going to come, but were not able to come, unfortunately. Because we always like to hear from the students. I do know a little about what the students would have spoken about, and that is the problems with water bottles. From the beginning to the end of the water bottle, it presents problems in the manufacture, you have the release of carbon, transportation, long way, so release of carbon there. People think that they're recycled, but the fact is that very few of the water bottles do get recycled. The rest end up in the garbage, and they don't break down. It takes many, many years for a plastic water bottle to break, or not really break down, but to photodegrade into very, very microscopic particles called nurdles. And they are there pretty well forever. They get washed into the water systems, and every year, about 1 million marine birds and fish die from ingesting this gelatinous plastic mass that's floating in our oceans called, one is called the Pacific Gyre. It's the size of Quebec. And we are at the top of that food chain. So I know the students would have talked a little bit about the health as well, but basically they are really concerned about the pollution. And they would have spoken to you about that tonight. And they asked me to pass along their regrets that they weren't able to come, but have issued you and Mayor Lehman an invitation to our school, Pope John Paul School, on April the 11th at 1:30. The date is still in the works, but you more than likely will be receiving something in writing. They also regret that they didn't get the letters that they had written to you in time. And they are thinking actually of having their own open delegation to you at some point in the future. So again, thank you very much for the opportunity to talk to you about this. And I really hope that you will look at the Council of Canadians website and pass a resolution that incorporates the 3 points and become Barrie's next blue community. And you can add that to your sign of fair trade. Okay? And I have a booklet here about what it means that I don't know who I should pass it to for council members. If any
our deputy clerk will come and like pick that up from you. Thank you.
For those of you, I just have just a little visual. This bottle represents oil. About that much oil is needed to make one water bottle. Here's another one. This is the amount of water that's required to manufacture one water bottle. And most of the water that's in here is tap water, and our Barrie water is good. Thank you very much.
Thanks very much. Other questions, members of council? Okay, Don, Mariane, thank you very much for bringing this to us. And I recently had the opportunity to meet a young woman from Kingston who is traveling the province speaking to municipalities, mayors, regarding Blue Community Initiative. And she was delighted to hear that the Council of Canadians was bringing this forward. It's certainly been a hot topic in specifically around bottled water in many municipalities. We sat around this table on Wednesday of last week, and for those who perhaps have forgotten or never knew, our drinking water here in Barrie is tested every 2 seconds. So you can't get much better than what's in this glass.
Versus the bottled water, which is maybe once a year.
Sure. Okay. Thank you very much for your delegation.
You're welcome.